Unraveling the new solution of the Fermi Paradox. Why we are alone. From the depths of space, a mysterious silence looms. The universe should be full of light. Yet we have found nothing but a frigid void of nothingness. Enrico Fermi asked the question, if intelligent life is common in the universe, then where is everybody? And with that, the Fermi Paradox has been proposed, ranging from the pessimistic to the optimistic, with some suggesting we are the only intelligent beings in the universe, while others pointing out that advanced civilizations may be actively hiding from us out of fear. In this video, we will examine the history of the Fermi Paradox, the various proposed solutions, and what the implications are for us here on Earth. Are we alone in the universe, or are we simply too noisy? The answer to these questions lie in the depths of the universe, and the truth may be more chilling than we could ever imagine. Watch this video to learn more, and try not to get any goosebumps. But before digging in the paradox, let's take a look at who Fermi was. Enrico Fermi was an Italian physicist widely known for his work on the development of the world's first nuclear reactor. He was a brilliant and innovative scientist who was able to use his knowledge to create something that has never been seen before. His work was so impressive that he is still remembered today as one of the great physicists of all time. He won the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1938, and his work has influenced countless of other scientists and engineers throughout the years. In addition to his work on the nuclear reactor, he developed the theory of beta decay, discovered transuranium elements, and even made important contributions to the development of quantum theory. He also worked on nuclear power, nuclear weapons, and other areas of physics. Fermi's discoveries have helped shape our modern world, and his legacy will continue to live on for generations to come. Fermi was also the one who initially posed the famous question, "Where is everybody?" The one that initiated the Fermi Paradox. This question was posed during a lunch conversation with colleagues in Los Alamos in 1950. The conversation was sparked by a cartoon showing aliens emerging from a flying saucer carrying trash cans stolen from New York City. Fermi concluded that interstellar travel might not be possible, might not be worth the effort, or a technological civilization might not last long enough to invent interstellar travel. This gave rise to the Fermi Paradox, which questions the existence of extraterrestrial civilizations. People have been searching for signs of intelligent alien life, yet have found no clear sign that anyone or anything is out there. Various solutions have been proposed to try to explain this enigma. Some suggest that we are the only intelligent life in the universe, while others say that advanced civilizations may be actively hiding from us out of fear. Stay with us to hear about the newest one. Let's start with the possibility that ancient civilizations do exist. Have you thought of the possibility that they could be hanging out around our galaxy, but deliberately hiding for them not to be found? Hear the solution of the Fermi Paradox. It's called the Dark Forest Theory. The Dark Forest Theory is like a really scary story. Imagine there is a big forest full of animals like lions, tigers, and bears. All the animals want to stay safe, so they all stay really quiet so they don't attract attention to themselves. That way, no one can find them and hurt them. That's kind of like the Dark Forest Theory. All the different civilizations out there in the universe don't want to make any noise or be discovered, so they stay quiet so they don't get hurt by a more powerful civilization. The mystery and danger of the Dark Forest Theory is that no one really knows what lies out there beyond our own galaxy. Are there even other civilizations out there, or is it only us? Could there be a powerful alien force lurking in the shadows, just waiting to strike? Keep watching to find out about the newest proposed solutions. Two researchers have recently proposed another possible solution to the Fermi Paradox. The newest bones suggesting that the lack of extraterrestrial visitation is due to a singularity caused by superlinear scaling. Their paper was published in the Journal of the Royal Society Interface. The proposed solution suggests that as civilizations grow, their technological capabilities scale faster than their population, leading to a singularity, where the amount of resources and energy available to a single individual exceeds the available resources for the whole civilization. The rest of this singularity is that the civilization collapses in on itself, unable to sustain its population size, resulting in its ultimate extinction. The researchers suggested that this phenomenon could explain why we have yet to detect signals from extraterrestrial civilizations. If civilizations tend to collapse from their own success, then there may be a limited number of civilizations in the galaxy that have managed to avoid the singularity and are now engaged in interstellar communication. The authors of the study went on to suggest that we should look for civilizations that have managed to stay in balance, avoiding the collapse of population, resulting in a more sustainable and potentially more populous universe, wherein interstellar communication is more commonplace. While the proposed theory is compelling, it must be acknowledged that it is just one of many possible explanations for the Fermi paradox. Further research is needed to confirm or refute the singularity hypothesis, and more information is needed to determine why and how civilizations are able to maintain a stable population and technological development. What can we do to quantify the solution of the Fermi paradox and determine if we are alone in the universe? Is there a way to evaluate how possible it is that we aren't alone? You're in luck, because scientists have done the research. When it comes to the study of extraterrestrial life, Frank Drake is a name that many astronomers and astrobiologists recognize. In 1960, Drake wrote an equation that sought to quantify the number of detectable civilizations in our galaxy. This pivotal equation is now known as the Drake equation, and it has become one of the most important tools used to estimate the odds of finding life beyond our planet. Frank Drake's equation begins with a list of 7 factors that can influence the number of detectable civilizations in the Milky Way. These include the rate of star formations, the fraction of stars that have planets, the average number of habitable planets per system, the fraction of habitable planets that actually develop life, the fraction of planets with life that evolves into an intelligent species, the fraction of intelligent civilizations that develop detectable technologies, and finally, the average time it would take those civilizations to produce such signs in years. Feeling dizzy yet? When these factors are plugged into Drake's equation, it can provide estimates of the number of detectable civilizations in our galaxy. But these numbers aren't fully precisely known now, which makes it pretty hard to know where to look. Since 1960, Drake's equation has been used by astronomers and astrobiologists to improve our understanding of the potential for finding extraterrestrial life. In addition to being useful in the search for extraterrestrial life, the equation has also been used to explore the possibility of interstellar travel, as well as the potential for interstellar communication. This concept is closely related to the idea of the Fermi paradox, which states that if intelligent civilizations exist in the universe, why haven't we detected any evidence of them? Scientists have proposed various explanations for this paradox, such as civilizations simply not wanting to communicate, or that our civilization may just be too young to join the galactic community. This paradox and the Drake equation have been the basis of many SETI, Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, initiatives, which aim to detect radio signals from other civilizations in the universe. SETI projects have been conducted since the 1960s and continue today, listening for any signs of intelligent life in space. Of course, the Drake equation does have its limitations. The values for the 7 variables are largely unknown, and so the equation is only as reliable as the data that is used. However, Drake's equation has become an invaluable tool in the scientific community, and its influence on our understanding of the universe and the potential for finding other forms of life is immense. Regardless of its limitations, it's impossible to deny the impact that Frank Drake's equation has had on how scientists and other interested individuals think about the potential for extraterrestrial life. As we continue to learn more about our universe, Drake's equation will remain an important part of the conversation. Ultimately, the Drake equation and the Fermi paradox prove that while life beyond Earth may exist, the chances of us ever encountering it are slim. But this doesn't mean that we should give up the search. For many, the hope of discovering an extraterrestrial civilization is a dream worth pursuing. And don't forget to like and subscribe to watch informative videos about the coolest subjects. The universe is an incredibly vast place, with an estimated 100 billion galaxies and more than 10 trillion stars in our own Milky Way alone. With such immense potential for life, it's easy to believe that life must exist elsewhere. In fact, the concept of extraterrestrial life is extremely popular among the general public and has long been a fixture in science fiction. Even mainstream science has suggested the possibility of intelligent life elsewhere in our galaxy and has even gone so far as to create the Drake equation to help predict the number of such civilizations. But what if, despite all these tantalizing possibilities, we are truly alone? Such a thought has many implications that could, in theory, be frightening. After all, if we are truly alone, then it means that there is nobody out there to help us in times of need, nobody to save us from ourselves, no alien race to provide us with the answers to all of our problems. On the other hand, such a realization could inject humanity with a renewed sense of purpose and motivation. Knowing that we are the only ones out there could empower us to find our own solutions to our own problems. It could help us to appreciate the unique beauty of our planet and to take better care of it. It could help our species come together in a way that it has never done before, to work towards a common goal of ensuring our own survival. The truth is, nobody knows for sure whether we are truly alone in the universe. One thing is certain, however, discovering the answer is an exciting prospect, one that will have profound implications for our species and our place in the universe. The Fermi Paradox has captivated minds for generations, and yet it remains as mysterious as ever. We have only theories and speculations, but no concrete evidence to back them up. So we are forced to wait and see what the future holds. Behind the silence of the universe lies a crucial question. Why hasn't anyone or anything responded to our calls for contact? Could it be that advanced civilizations have simply moved on to another plane of existence? Could it be that intelligent life is just too rare in our universe to be detected? Or could it be that intelligent life is actively trying to hide from us out of fear? It's hard to say, but the Fermi Paradox will continue to haunt us until we find the ultimate answer. Let us know what you think. Which of these solutions sounds more likely to be true according to you? Comment below on the video. We are interested in what you think. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. See you later.